This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, good morning to you all. Now, we will see the different data types made available by Python. Have a look at this table. Have a look at these two numbers. Both of them are whole numbers. What do I mean? They don't have any fractional part. Such numbers are known as integers. So this is technically known as the integer data type. See, in the programming field, you have to provide the input and then write instructions to process them and then write one more or a set of instructions to display the outputs. So there you have to deal with values. Such values may be either whole numbers or fractional numbers. See, here these two numbers don't have any fractional part, but these two numbers have fractional parts. Such numbers are known as floating point numbers. This is the second data type that is widely used in Python. When I want to talk about my age, say I will use the integer data type. On the other hand, when I want to talk about my height or weight, I will make use of the floating point data type. Now, the third one is complex number data type. In the good old days, when we were in the school, we talked about the complex number. The familiar form of the complex number is x plus iy. Here also we are writing it in the same form. We very rarely use this data type. Now what about the Boolean data type? Now all of us would have heard about Boolean algebra, right? In the normal decimal system, we have the digits. We have the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., 9. But in the case of the binary system, we have only two digits, 0 and 1. Since the word true represents the value 1, the value false represents the value 0, right? Now, this is the string data type. See, anything that you write within double quotations is known as a string. I can write my name within double quotes. I can write my role within double quotes and so on. In Python, instead of using double quotes, you can also use single quotes to represent a string constant. Now, have a look at the next three entries. Next three entries are list, tuple, and dictionary. These three are widely used in the Python environment. See, I am writing five values within a pair of square brackets. Here, I am writing four values within a pair of square brackets. So let me tell you what is a list. It's very simple. A list is a collection of values. Say, what do I mean? I write 1, 2, 3, 4 values. So collection of four values. I write this collection of four values within square bracket, right? So the certain points to be remembered regarding lists are this. Number one, it is a collection of values. Collection of four values or five values or 10 values or 20 values. Number two, right? The beginning of the list should be indicated by a square bracket and the end of the list should also be indicated by a square bracket. Third point, two values should be separated by a comma. Two values should be separated by a comma. Fourth point, you can very well have different data types within the same list. Here, all the values are integers, but here you have a string, two integers and a fraction number. This is allowed. And the last point is this. Now, at the time of defining this list, I write the name Neha here, but after some time, I can change this name or this value or this value or this value. This nature of list is known as the mutable nature of list. Mutable means change is allowed. You, at the time of defining a list, you can define in one way. Later on, you can change any value if there is a need to do so. Now, what is a tuple? For all practical purposes, tuple is just like a list. Here also, you talk about a list of values. Right here also the values are separated by commas. Here also different data types are allowed. Now the main difference between list and tuple is this one, right? List is known as mutable, but tuple is immutable. What do I want to say? Suppose you define a tuple like this. After some time, if you want, you cannot change this value or this value or this value or this value. If at all you want to make any change, you have to store the new collection under a different name. Is the rough idea clear? Of course, there is one important simple difference. Here you use the square brackets to represent the list, but here you use the round brackets instead. Now, what is the next important data type? It is known as dictionary. Assume that my name is Muthu. My weight is 65 kilograms, my height is 155 centimeter, and my BMI value is 20. Now, I want to represent all these values about myself, right, as a collection. So in such situations, I will use a dictionary. The details about one person, his name, weight, height, and BMI value. Here, see, this is known as the key, and this is known as its value. And the whole thing is known as a pair. And once again, see, this is the second pair, third pair, fourth pair. In the second pair, weight is known as the key, and 65 is known as the value. Here, this is the key, this is the value. This is the key, this is the value. So, can I say that dictionary is a collection of pairs of values? Here, how many pairs we have? First pair, second pair, third, fourth pair. So, here, it is a collection of four pairs. The most important point to be remembered regarding the dictionary is one, is this one. In the case of list and tuple, this one is known as a zeroth value. First value, second value, third value. Here also this is known as a zeroth value, first value, second value, third value. Now if I tell the computer, come on, pull out the zeroth value, it will provide me the value nega. Pull out the first value, it will provide 83. But here, and these values, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, the positions, they are known as indices. Now what do I want to say? By using an index, you can retrieve a value in the case of a list or tuple. But here, you cannot use the index concept. Instead, you have to use the key concept. Now I have to tell the computer, come on, provide the value that is associated with this key. Or if I want to know the weight, I have to tell the computer, come on, provide the value that is associated with this key. Instead of defining the index, I have to specify the key. Okay, now the last one is very, very easy to understand. None. Sometimes, right, we are not able to provide any value, right, at a particular time. You see, a variable does not have a value as of now. Probably we will be able to fill it up at a later stage. So for the time being, temporarily, we will store none as the value of this variable. Is a rough idea clear? So these are the various data types which are often used in Python. Thank you.